Hello. We have a 10-minute AMRAP today, so nice and quick. But our goal is for the 15 thrusters that we're doing, the goal is to keep it unbroken. So makes it a little bit harder, but if absolutely necessary, try to break it into five, so three sets of five, or if you want to do a set of eight and then a set of seven, that's fine too. But goal is to have it unbroken. After that, we have five double presses if you're doing double dumbbell, and it's going to be six double presses if you're doing single arm, and we will go over that. So that counts as one round, 15 thrusters, preferably unbroken, into five double dumbbell double presses or six single arm double presses. And that's it. Pretty quick workout, but it will be a good one.
Okay, here we go. We're starting with jumping jacks. Squats. Some glute bridges. Go up for round two. Doing our lunges. I forgot I'm recording sometimes. Let's get into it. Intro arms, low push up. Waking waking up our butt, waking up our hamstrings, making sure the core is tight here. That is it. Okay. Let's grab a dumbbell and let's do our dumbbell warm up. Okay. So that one, just be mindful of where you start so that we try to stay as even as possible. So yes, I know it's going to be a possible one extra rep, but I want you to be mindful so that you can even yourself out, even if you're going into the next movement. Same thing here. Keep count of how many swings you do on one side. Try to even it on the other side. On the second round of your dumbbell swings, we are going overhead because we're prepping for our double presses, which are overhead. Our dumbbell warm up. We'll get into our movements for the workout on the next cut of this video. Okay, so let's warm up our thrusters. If you are going to be doing dumbbells for your thrusters and you have lighter weight, warm up with the lighter weight before you go to your heavier weight or your working weight. If you're using barbell, as always, we're gonna go onto our lighter or empty bar, and let's do our thrusters from there. Let's do 5 of these. We are going to be going for unbroken later, so make sure those shoulders feel good. Make sure your legs feel good. Is that 5? I don't remember. I was talking. After you did your 5, we're going to add our weight. So if you're dumbbells, again, go into your heavier dumbbells. If you are barbell, we're going to add on our weight. So the weight I have written for today, anywhere between 55 to 75. Your choice, if you want to count do that 75. It's gonna be tough. 65 is gonna be tough too. I mean, thrusters in general are tough as a movement. I'm gonna try to go for 15 on Monday. That is the goal. If you wanna do, again, in fives, you can. If you wanna do an 8 and a 7, that gets you to 15 as well. It is a 10-minute AMRAP, so it goes by pretty quickly. That pushing yourself a little bit harder in trying to get that 15 unbroken is the goal. And once you load your weight up, let's do another 5. Make sure you're breathing. So take your time, doesn't have to be fast. Breath is in, breathe out. Then catch your breath right here, right before you go back down, breathe out. Okay, so take your time on it. We're gonna do another 5. If you wanna follow my pace, by all means, on the warm-up, I'm gonna try to go a little bit slower so that I can pace my breathing, especially when the workout is going and you are more out of breath. Try your best to catch your breath in the movement. So, let's get going. Next is our devil presses. So it comes out into a burpee, comes up, swing up overhead. I'm gonna have a start with at least a single dumbbell so that we can feel it out, see how you feel. And let's do 4 of those. So dumbbells off to your side, pop out, and then when you pop back in, big swing in between the legs and up overhead. Then come down, switch to the other side if you're doing singles later. So that's our single. We also have the option of double. And you have both dumbbells on either side. Still jump out into your burpee, big swing of both. I like to squeeze the dumbbells together and try to make it into one thing so it's like a kettlebell swing up and over. Yes, your hand placement's a little different, but that's what we have when we're doing different, when we're using different equipment. So if you're gonna try double dumbbell, warm that up. If you want to just try it out for the warm-up and not do it for the workout, that's fine too. I'm gonna do 2. Use those glutes. Okay. So before we get going again, we have in one round, it is 15 thrusters, preferably unbroken, 5 double presses if you're doing double dumbbell, 6 double presses if you're doing single dumbbell. Ready to get going? Let's get to it. Let's get to it. We got a 10-minute AMRAP. Breathe. Under three.
That was a good one. I'm still trying to catch my breath. 15 unbroken thrusters is no joke. I hope you all did good or felt good about it. And what else do I have to say? Not much. Make sure you put your scores in and we got strength next.
For our strength, we have 12 alternating bent over rows. What we're gonna be holding at the top. So when you are holding at the top, we wanna try to squeeze our upper back so that your scaps backwards and your lats. Try to keep those engaged when you are holding, and we're gonna alternate. So it's gonna be 12 total, six on each side, and making sure our core is tight to support our low back. What else do I have to say? Not much. So let's get to it. Okay, so We're gonna be holding at the top. So first row to hold at the top, and then we're alternating. So you should feel that shakiness at the top because we are holding load there, and so pretty much all I gotta say about that. Our second movement is our bent over reverse flies. So we're working those same muscles. Think about opening and then pacing yourself back down. Opening and then with the tempo back down. Not too long of a tempo. You're definitely gonna need something lighter than you were for the rows. I'm gonna try. Eights, and we're gonna do 12 of these. So no hold, but try to have a tempo when you come back down. So still bent over, keep that tight belly. We do 4 rounds total, and I have time today to do it with you. Oh, I take my time. You move as you do, but if you're keeping pace with me, I'm gonna chill for a little bit. Oh man, that workout was tough. I think my legs started to burn out quicker than my shoulders, but then towards the end, everything was pretty tired. Feeling good? Hope so. I know working out with friends is always more fun, so that's why I talk to the camera. Because I hope that whoever's working out with me is responding. Okay, we're halfway. Feeling pretty swole up top. Oh, my shoulders. Definitely feeling them now. So on the rows, you may feel a little bit of delt. Mainly I want you to feel those lats pinching. Not pinching, but squeezing. Keeping those contracted and down when you're growing. Thank you.
it comes to strength, do give yourself breaks in between your sets so that we can let the lactic acid inside your muscles subside for a little bit and then we can get going again. Because you shouldn't be working to fatigue every single time when it comes to strength. And there we are. We finished all our Mekan and strength and ready to have a good day. Well, if you're doing this in the evening, I hope you already had a good day. If you're doing this in the morning like I am, hope you're ready to enjoy the rest of your day. But regardless, glad you worked out with me today. And that's about it. See you next time.